chair and members.
Okay, we'll call it to order. The regular meeting of the Board of Public Safety, today's date is March 28, 2012. Let's begin all our meetings with a recitation of the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic which stands one nation under God, indivisible, liberty, and justice for all.
Madam Secretary, can you state the obvious and do a roll call, please?
Richard Morrisroll.
Present.
Richard Chumzinski.
Present.
Thomas Davis.
Present.
Okay, we have minutes to approve of our March 14th meeting. And approve them without reading.
I make the motion.
Second.
Roll call, please.
Richard Morrisroll.
Approve.
Richard Chumzinski.
Approve.
Thomas Davis.
Approve.
Under new business, we'll take up the business of code enforcement.
Good afternoon, members of our board. I'm hoping that everybody received my report in your packages.
Yes.
From Ms. Cosme, and if you have any questions, I'm here to answer them. It's lengthy. Instead of putting some bullet points, I'd put a little bit of description, simply since it's about a month in between our meetings. And I gave you an update from the last time we had a department head meeting with some facts and figures. So if you have any questions, I'm here to answer them for you.
I have an inquiry from a citizen about the police powers of code enforcement officers.
Yes.
Is one of their procedures to check the driver's license of the person who is being challenged?
No. No, and the reason that is, if you remember, the one thing that we were not to engage in is any moving violations. So it's strictly the code violations, which is still those of the codes. And if it's any vehicle at all, it would be a non-moving vehicle, basically a parking situation.
But not procedurally for identification purposes.
And the reason we would say no, we have no access to that, okay, to call anybody and ask them to run IDEX or anything like that. No.
Thank you.
Hmm?
I have no question.
No question?
I got a question.
Yes, sir.
What happened to those collection of delinquent accounts that
he'd be happy.
Controller were working together.
He would happy to know that working with attorney Don Dawkins, yep, finalized as of Friday before last, the paperwork to give us the actual lien that is acceptable for us to use. And in a matter of a day, our wonderful administrative assistant Gloria was able to finalize them and transpose them. So I have that total 280 liens to be assessed and given to Commissioner Guzman, because it's going to have to come out of her budget since we don't have one, and take them down to Crown Point so we could actually just put them, but everything is ready to go.
We're not going to write off anything. We're going to place liens on the front.
Liens on all 280 that we have on, yes.
Good job.
The only thing that would have been is that we actually decided not to pursue the 2010, because it was going to be kind of troublesome with some of the evidence at that time.
Okay. Any other questions for Mr. Hernando?
Okay. Thank you.
Accept his report then.
Thank you.
I shall move.
I second the motion.
Roll call.
Richard Morrisroll.
Accept.
Richard Chumzinski.
Accept.
Thomas Davis.
Accept.
The next item on the agenda is the business of the building department.
Good evening, Wina Guzman, Building Commissioner for the City of East Chicago, Building Department. I don't know if I could start off with reports. Do you want me to start off with reports?
Yes, you would like to proceed?
Yes, as far as status reports, written report is hereby submitted, which I did today, for the month of February 2012 through March 2012. Reflecting recent board up demolition and other activities relating to the building department. You have any questions on that?
No, I don't.
I do not. Do you?
No, no questions.
Okay.
We accept that report, though, and thank you for it.
You're welcome. Okay, 4841 through 43 Alexander. I'm bringing this property before this board for condemnation demolition. I would like to share these photos with the board.
Has anyone come representing that property today?
Yes, yes. We have interested party in the audience, yes.
I just about seen all this. Up and down.
This is a commercial two-story brick wood frame structure which has been abandoned and vacant pursuant to our records since 2003. As you will note on the notice, there are approximately 51 building code violations pertaining to the exterior of this building. The rear section of this structure has partially collapsed, leaving remaining structure unsound and on verge of collapse. Notices to appear have been properly served upon owners and interested parties via first class mail, certified mail, and publication. Would you like me to make my recommendation, or would you like for the owner of record to come before?
If you don't with your presentation, then we'll move on.
Yes, and then I could present my recommendation.
Okay. Anyone interested in speaking to this property, please step forward.
Oblet.
If you want to be heard, ma'am, please step to the podium. Identify yourself.
Yeah, she said it's been vacant since 2003. It's been vacant since 2009.
Excuse me, ma'am, please state your name for the record.
I'm Margaret O'Neill.
Okay.
I own the property. And it's been vacant since 2009.
Okay. Is there any other information you would like to share with the board?
That, look, taxes and stuff are so high, I can't even afford it anymore. I haven't paid the taxes since, I think, the first of 2010.
Okay.
Because, you know, like, it went from 500 and something to 2,000, 1980-something, 1890-something, 4,000, 3,000. Hey, I'm retired.
Ma'am, if I may, do you dispute the condition of the property as described by the building commissioner?
No, I don't. I don't know exactly what was described. It don't have an awning and all that, but the building is in bad condition.
Okay. My next question to you, ma'am, is do you intend on repairing it?
No, I don't. Can't afford it.
Okay. Any questions of the board based on my questions to this individual?
Ma'am, have you seen the pictures that we were presented today of the building?
No, I haven't.
Would you look at them and just see if they, she has them, the commissioner? Here, I'm sorry. Thank you. You're requesting that the building be demolished?
Yes. Dr. Barron. Yeah, that's the back. What is this?
That is the back.
Oh, it's still the back. That's the back. Just the back.
Yeah.
Oh. Look, I got klutzy fingers.
In the back.
Oh, this the back.
Yeah.
Let's get to the front. That's that side over there. That's the flat. Oh.
Can I take that?
Yes, ma'am, just to identify yourself and then, you're with Ms. O'Neill, are you not? You're with Ms. O'Neill. You're with Ms. O'Neill.
I'm her sister.
Okay. And could you just give us your name and then make the remarks that you wanted to?
My name is Irma Sneed. This is my sister. Some of the damage was caused, like some of that damage to the front and the side of the building. Well, some of it was damaged when that store caught on fire.
And they tore it apart.
And they pulled that.
What is this?
When they tore that, that's right there on that side in the front, where they tore the store down, they pulled that beam down, and they damaged the property. Some of them bricks on the front that was destroyed after the building, that was destroyed when they had that movie made. And they was doing all that exploding and stuff they were supposed to fix. They never fixed anything. Now that back porch did fall in, it collapsed.
It collapsed when I was there.
It collapsed.
Yeah.
The porch collapsed, the bottom part, not the building part, but the back part, it collapsed.
This here. And it
so most of what you seeing is the back of the building. Those windows in the front, what they had on that report about them falling down, my father put brand new windows in that across the front. So they just fell down because it wasn't locked in the sash. So, I mean, it is bad, and it's a lot of damage.
But Ms. Sneed, we're not faulting you and Ms. O'Neill about it. We're just saying the condition seems to be dangerous, and that's why the commissioner has come forward.
And then people have broken into it. That's why a lot of this stuff is damaged, because people have broken into it since she moved out.
We're appreciative that you've come here this afternoon.
But it a lot of this did fall because part of the back porch fell while I was there, and that was in 2009.
Let me ask you one question, Ms. O'Neill. You said you're not able to pay it. You've been, it's retired. What are your plans? What were your plans? Do we just let it sit there?
I don't have any
plan. Okay, then.
You all want the property, you got it.
What about you, sister? What about you?
Ain't nothing I can do with it.
Okay.
I can't afford it either.
That's all I wanted to know. Thank you.
I don't think it's so much we want the property as the building seems to be unsafe. And so if nobody pays the taxes, the property probably will go to the city. But it's not, we're not tearing it down because we want the property. To please understand that. It's just the condition of the building is such
that
we think we should have to do something about it.
You're right.
And there's nothing to do about it.
Well, as I say, I'm appreciative you've come today.
Thank you.
I'll make my recommendation now.
Okay, go ahead.
Thank you, Ms. O'Neill. You can have a seat. Okay. Again, this property is in violation of the unsafe building law. It poses an immediate danger to the life, health, and safety of passersby and neighboring properties. And I'm recommending that the board affirm my order to condemn and demolish and give the owners 30 days to demolish the property. And I'm also recommending that if the owner fails and or refuses to comply within the specified time period, that this board impose a $1,000 civil penalty against the owner of record. And that's my recommendation.
Ma'am, do you both, is it owned by both of you? Or by Ms. O'Neill?
Just you?
Yes.
Ms. O'Neill, are you able to afford to tear it down?
I can afford to tear it down.
Well, we will.
I refuse. We simply don't have the money. Fine's been.
Continue.
Yes, and that's my recommendation.
I don't think the city should be responsible for tearing down somebody else's property. I think the owner should be responsible, made responsible for tearing down, you know, such property. It's in a dilapidated state. It's unsafe. Meets the criteria under the unsafe building law. And, you know, I stand firm on my recommendation.
I make a motion that we authorize the building commissioner to tear the building down.
My recommendation is to give the owners 30 days to take it down. And after that, if they fail to comply, then the city will place it on the demolition list. And as funds are available, then, you know, we can proceed with demolishing the property. But at this time, my recommendation is to give the owners 30 days to order the owners 30 days to demolish the property.
If I understand the owners, you could demolish it tomorrow if you want. It's not a matter of the time, it's a matter of the resources. I mean, if you want to comply and add the 30 days, I don't think that's an issue. I think you could add it to your list whenever you'd like.
Yes, and that's true. But it's a matter of record and the process that we have to follow.
Then to so do.
Okay. And as far as the civil penalty?
I will not recommend a civil penalty.
The motion on the floor is the board authorizes demolition of the building in question.
So moved.
Second.
Roll call.
Richard Morrisroll.
Order to demolish.
Richard Chemzinski.
Demolish.
Thomas Davis.
To demolish.
That motion carries.
Thank you.
Any other business?
3926 Drummond. This is a property that was brought up before this board. There was an order to repair entered on June 22nd, 2011. Motion was made and is accepted to order owner to repair by February 22nd, 2012. If the owner failed or refused to comply by that time frame, a $1,000 civil penalty was to be imposed. And I just wanted to advise the board that the property is in compliance, and I'm hereby recommending that the board rescind its $1,000 civil penalty imposed as the owner, Manuel Chacon, has complied with the order to repair.
Should we submit that to a vote, council?
Sure. Motion to accept the building commissioner's recommendation to rescind penalty and show the property in compliance.
So moved.
Second motion.
Roll call.
Richard Morrisroll.
Rescind.
Richard Chemzinski.
Rescind.
Thomas Davis.
Rescind.
Thanks, property, Madam Secretary. Or Madam Commissioner.
That's okay. That completes my report. As far as the demolitions, that's just to advise the board on the statuses of the current demolitions going on within our city. The notice of emergency order to demolish, that's listed on the report that was submitted today. And if you have any further questions.
The Todd property is not... we're not bringing that forward, or it's already been addressed?
No, they've hired a contractor to repair, so we're awaiting repairs of the of the wall.
Thank you.
Yes. That completes my report.
Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Building Commissioner.
Thank you.
Any other business to be brought before the board? You know, we got a somewhat full house here. Public comments? Questions, inquiries? Our next scheduled meeting will be held on April 11, 2012 at 5:30 p.m. No other business being brought before the board. Motion to adjourn would be appropriate.
I so move.
I second the motion.
Roll call.
Richard Morrisroll.
Adjourn.
Richard Chemzinski.
Adjourn.
Thomas Davis.
Adjourn.
Meeting's now adjourned.
Thank you. Thank you.